Welcome you all. Today's topic of discussion is sex versus gender and the social construction of gender. I'll be telling you the fact that generally sex and gender, these two concepts are interchangeably used. But actually both the concepts are not same. Rather, there is a huge difference between two concepts. For example, I am telling you, sex is a biological attribute. On the other hand, gender is a socio-cultural attribute. While we see sex difference, we basically see the physical difference, the genetic difference between man and woman. For example, there exists difference in appearance of man and woman. There exists difference in the voice, speech pattern of man and woman. There exists difference in the genetic composition or constitution between man and woman. For example, the sex chromosome of a man is XY. On the other hand, the sex chromosome of a woman is XX. So while this difference in genetic composition of man and woman is taken into account, when the difference in appearance between man and woman is taken into account, whenever the difference between speech pattern, voice of man and woman is taken into account, there the concept comes which is called sex difference. That's the reason at the beginning I told you the fact that sex is a biological attribute, it's a physiological attribute. What is the biological and physical difference between man and woman? The bodily construction of man is not same as woman. The appearance of man is not same as woman. The voice of a man is not same as woman. While we focus our attention on these type of differences between man and woman, at that point of time, we basically discuss the concept which is called sex or sex difference. On the contrary, gender is a socio-cultural attribute. Gender is a socio-cultural attribute. What a society expects, what our society expects a man to do, and what our society expects a woman to do. Our society does not expect man and woman to do the same thing. In traditional India, particularly, men and women, they were expected to do different things. For example, men were expected to go for outside activities, that to go to the agricultural field and work there. On the contrary, in traditional India, women were expected to be engaged in domestic activities. This was the expectation of society. In matter of behavior of man and woman, while we focus our attention on the expectation of society on man and woman, at that point of time, we reach at the concept which is called gender difference. So, for the purpose of explaining sex difference, we use the concept that is man and woman, man versus woman, that refers to sex difference. On the contrary, for the purpose of explaining gender difference, we use the concept that is masculine versus feminine. Means our society in tradition ridden days expected men to behave, to work, to do in one way, and our society expected women to work or do in some other way. While the expectation of society was taken into consideration, at that point of time, we reached at the concept that is called gender difference. Now, you come to the topic that is social construction of gender. The meaning of this topic is that what role society plays in the matter of teaching the difference between masculine and feminine gender role. As I told you earlier, you see, while children are born or infants are born, they are born only with sex difference. You see, one day in a family, suppose a male child, male infant and female infant was born. At the point of birth, seeing the bodily structure of male and female infant, we can reach at the conclusion that, okay, he is the male infant, she is the female infant. So, at birth, a child or an infant was having only sex difference. There was biological difference between male infant and female infant. But what happened? Gradually the infant grows. While the infant grows in the family, right now, the elderly member of the family, they teach the infant that it is a male infant or it is a female infant. While that infant grows, suppose 1 year is complete, then the person is called child. Infancy means starting from birth till completion of 1 year of age. Childhood means after completion of 1 year till attainment of 6 years of age, this period of life is called childhood. So, at the point of birth, infant was born only with sex difference. But right now, infant got converted into child after conversion of 1 year of age. Right now, the infant started growing up in family, reached at the age of 2, 3, 4, 5, like that. So while the infant started growing, child started growing, right now, the elderly member of the family, they told the child that he is a male child or she is a female child. And right now, the elderly member of the family, they taught the child that male child's behavior is not same as the female child's behavior. There must be difference in the behavior of the male child and female child. Then the child also crossed the age of 6, reached at 7, 8, 9, 10, and subsequently also reached at adolescent stage of life, 13 and 14 years of age. So right now, starting from childhood stage till the attainment of adolescent stage, elderly member of the family, they started teaching the child that he is a male child, he is expected to behave in this way, or she is a female child, she is expected to behave in another way. If he is a male child, he should be bold and brave. If she is a female child, she should be shy and submissive. In traditional Indian society, this type of teaching was given to male and female children. So right now, the child came to know the fact that as I am a male child, I am expected to behave in this way. I should be bold and brave. And at the same time, if the child is a female child, that female child started learning the fact that I am a female child. I should not be aggressive by attitude. Rather, I should be very much submissive by attitude. I should be shy by nature. So you see, all these features were not there with the infant while it was born. But right now, it is the society which is teaching the male child to behave in one way and female child to behave in another way. So in this way, it's society. Society means it's our parents. It's our close relatives in family. They are teaching us that being male children, we would behave in that way. Being female children would behave in this way. So in this way, it is society which is teaching the gender role to the children. So what role society is playing, what role culture is playing in the matter of teaching gender role to the male and female, while that is taken into consideration, we reach at the concept which is called the social construction of gender. That is today's topic of discussion. You know, these days, all over the world, the difference between masculine and feminine gender role is getting reduced. But in traditional societies all over the world, including Africa, Asia, and America, everywhere, there was existing a huge gender difference. But today it's getting abridged. I will be discussing it. So you see, as I am discussing the topic, that is social construction of gender, I will cite many examples in context of Indian society. Just let you sensitize what role a society like India was playing in the matter of teaching the difference between masculine role and feminine role. You see, take for example, suppose there is a family in which there is a male child and there is a female child. As I told you earlier, at the point of birth, there was no difference in the behavioral pattern of male and female infant. There was only difference in the appearance of the male and female infant. But right now, while the boy and girls of the family started growing up, suppose reached at the age of 6, 7, 8, in traditional India, I am telling you, the male child was taught that he is a male child, he should be bold and brave, he should not shed a tear at every instance while he faces any harassment, because a male is not expected to shed a tear the moment he is experiencing any problem. On the other hand, in traditional Indian society, the elderly member of the family, they started teaching a female child that you are a female child. Your behavior should be very submissive behavior. You should take soft step, so soft that it is barely audible to other. Taking long stride, taking long step is unbecoming of feminine behavior. So take soft step, so soft that it is barely audible to other. You see, I have come from a coastal village of Odisha. During my childhood days, I have remembered the fact that while we children were growing up in patrilocal, patrilineal and patriarchal rural social setting in a coastal village of Odisha. In our village, there were many senior members, elderly members of the locality. And if a girl was dancing, jumping, shouting for food or hopping, the senior people of the family of the locality where I was growing up during my childhood stage, they were criticizing the girl by saying, "Why do you behave like a boy?" On the contrary, in our locality, while our friends, those who are children at that point of time, they were growing up, and whenever they were facing harassment and they were crying by shedding tears, senior members of their family as well as senior members of our village, they were also criticizing the boy by saying, "Why do you cry always like a girl?" In this way, I will be telling you the fact that gender-specific behavior was taught to us during our childhood days. In this way, it's not a situation only in my village where I was growing up. This situation was persisting in the entire length and breadth of our country, by which the male and female children of the locality, they were taught what is the unbecoming behavior, what is the unbelievable behavior on part of a girl, and what is the unbecoming and unbelievable behavior on part of a boy. In this way, what is appropriate behavior, what is inappropriate behavior, as per the gender of the people, that was taught to them, to the children, while they were growing up in society. A male child, father purchased doll and a miniature kitchen item for the daughter. Why? Because father is teaching the daughter that you are a daughter, you are expected to play with kitchen items. And father is teaching the son that you are my son. You are expected to become brave and bold. So use, hold this brick, hold this gun in your hand and try to become bold and brave. Was there any difference between the behavior of the male and female infant while both of them were born in family? No, absolutely not. But while they are growing up, parents are purchasing different playing items for them. Parents are teaching them, you are a male child, you should play with these items. You are a female child, you are expected to play with these types of items. So who is teaching gender role to us? Our biology doesn't have any role to play with our gender role. Our biology is dealing with sex differences, but it's our society and it's our culture which is dealing with gender role differences. I can cite innumerable number of examples from Indian society just to make you understand the difference between gender role. You see, in Indian society, women are regarded as goddess Annapurna. Goddess Annapurna means the unfailing supplier of food. As women are regarded as goddess Annapurna, our society expected that women in our society should not shout for food. But women will feel hungry. But if she feels hungry, she should not shout for food. So you see, while both the boys and girls, the example that I cited, they were growing up in the same family. Mother taught the daughter that you may feel hungry, but you should not shout for food. But your brother, he is a male, he can shout for food. You take soft step. Your brother can take very long step. In traditional Indian society, girls were expected not to sit with a cross-legged position. They were not supposed to sit with cross-legged position. They were not supposed to jump and dance. They were not expected to shout. On the other hand, their brothers were expected to shout. Apart from that, I am telling you, societies all over the world are patriarchal. Our society is also patriarchal to a larger extent. So you see, in traditional India, while the girl attained puberty, that is biological maturity, elderly member like grandmother and mother, they taught the girl that the real stage of your life came. Get mentally prepared to go to the house of the husband. You see, it's a very interesting thing you might have seen in movies that at the end of the marriage, the bride is expected to stand with a handful of rice by making her back towards the natal home in which she was born and brought up, and she was expected to throw this handful of rice over her shoulder. This is indicative of the fact that how much rice she had consumed until then, that would be paid back to the father with a single handful of rice. So, all these examples that I am citing, these examples bear testimony to the fact that it's our society, it's our cultural value which is teaching the man to behave in one way, and it's our society and cultural value which is teaching the woman to behave in another way. So in this way, I can say in a nutshell, what role society and culture is playing to show the difference between a man's behavior and a woman's behavior. While that role of society and culture is taken into consideration, we get the concept that is called social construction of gender. This is all about the answer of the topic, that is social construction of gender. In the next class, I will teach you feminism different types of feminism like liberal feminism, radical feminism, Marxist and socialist feminism, post-colonial feminism, and black feminism. Apart from that, I would also discuss the different waves of feminism like first wave of feminism, second wave of feminism, third wave of feminism, and fourth wave of feminism. Let me wind up the class for today. Thank you.